This is part 5 of Azure tutorial. In this video, we'll understand what are Azure resources and resource groups. First, let's say what are Azure resources. Resources are instances of Azure services that you create, like virtual machines, app services, storage accounts, SQL databases, function apps, etc. All these are Azure services. So every time you create an instance of a service, you are creating an Azure resource. There are hundreds of Azure services. You can see the complete list of services by navigating to this URL. Obviously, you need to log into the Azure portal, otherwise it will redirect you to the login page. On the left, you see the service categories like general, compute, networking, storage, etc. For example, if you want to create a storage account to store your data, click on the storage category and then you obviously see all the services related to storage. Now, let's say we are developing a web application and we want to store all images and videos related to our web application in a storage account. So let's create a storage account. I simply hover the mouse over storage accounts and then click create. Storage account is an Azure service and we are creating an instance of that service right here. So what we are essentially doing is creating an Azure resource. And anytime when we create an Azure resource, the first thing that we obviously need to select is the subscription. At the moment, I'm using my free trial subscription. So that's what is selected here. And then we need to select a resource group. We don't have any resource groups yet. So first, let's create a resource group. Before that, let's understand what is a resource group. As the name implies, a resource group is a group of Azure resources like virtual machines, app services, storage accounts, SQL databases, etc. It's a logical container for grouping related Azure resources. Let's say we are developing a web application. There are several ways to do this. To keep this example simple, let's just assume we need the following three Azure resources. First, a virtual machine. We need this to host and run our web application. And then a storage account to store images, videos, and any other resources that our web application needs. And then finally, a SQL database to store our application data. Now, let's say for this example's sake, we have the following environments. Most organizations have these deployment environments: development, testing, staging, pre-production, and production. Let's say our web application name is prejimtech.com. We might create the following four resource groups, one for each environment. Now, if you notice the names of these resource groups, we have a naming pattern here. The prefix RG stands for resource group, and then we have a dash, and then our application name, in this case, prejimtech, and then another dash, and followed by that, our deployment environment name, development, staging, pre-production, or production. Now, in this example, we are grouping the resources by deployment environment, and it is just one way of grouping. Obviously, you can group resources any way you want, any way that makes sense to your organization, really. By department, by country, by application, by resource type, or a combination of these. In general, resources that share the same deployment lifecycle are grouped. So these resources can be easily provisioned, that is, created, deployed, updated, and deleted as a single unit. There are several benefits of grouping resources. First, let's create a resource group. One way to do that is by clicking on this create new link on this create storage account page, or click on all services and then make sure you click on this all category here. So we have all the services listed. Search for resource group using this search text box. And then we want to create the resource group. So let's click this button. A resource group is also a resource. So as usual, anytime when we create an Azure resource, the first thing that we need to select is the subscription. I'm using my free trial subscription, and then we need to provide a name for our resource group. I'm going to use the naming pattern that we have just seen on the slide, RG for resource group, dash our application name, prejimtech, dash the deployment environment name. So let's create a resource group for development environment. Next, we need to specify the Azure region. Let's actually select India. Notice when I type India, we see all the Azure regions in India geography. Let's select South India. It is this region where the metadata about this resource group will be stored. But then one important point to keep in mind is the resources themselves that we add to this resource group can be in any Azure region. They don't necessarily have to be in the same region as this resource group. Next, we can add tags if we want, but then we'll discuss tags in a later video. For now, let's review this resource group and create it. There we go. Our resource group is created. And to see that resource group, we can click on this resource groups icon here or click on more services. This obviously takes us to the all services page and here search for resource groups. And then click on resource groups. There we go. We see our resource group. And when I click on the name, it takes us to the overview page of our resource group. Now, in Azure terms, these tabs that we see on the left here are called blades. At the moment, we are on the overview blade. When I click on tags, we are on the tags blade. And notice on the overview blade, we see this message, no resources to display. So in this resource group at the moment, we don't have any resources. Let's add an Azure resource. Let's search for storage account. And then click create. Subscription is free trial, and notice it has selected by default the resource group that we have just created. If you want, you can create a new resource group. And then let's specify a unique name for our storage account. Since this is a storage account, I'm going to prefix it with ST for storage, and then Pragime Tech Data, because we're going to use this storage account to store images, videos, and any other resources our web application needs. Next, we have location. Notice it defaulted to South India. Remember, this is the region where we have our resource group created. But then you're not limited to South India Azure region. You can select any region you want. We'll discuss the rest of these options in a later video. For now, let's review and create this storage account. There we go. Our storage account is successfully created. Now, let's navigate to our resource group by clicking on the resource group name right here. There we go. In our resource group, at the moment, we have just one resource, a storage account. In Azure, resource groups are very important. They offer several benefits. We'll discuss these benefits in detail in our next video.